Welcome to Unwritten Stories of Significance. It's going to be a great show, guys, because we have a returning guest that has graced this platform for two shows. In fact, two shows. And she's returning back. She lives in Bulgaria. With no further ado, I'd like to welcome Ilina Kostadinova. Hi, Ilina.
Hi, Joy. Thank you for having me on your show again. It's always a pleasure to be on.
Oh, you are welcome. I'm going to say this. I've been practicing. Dobar den.
Yeah. Good day in Bulgarian.
Yes. Good day, sweetheart. I've been practicing. I didn't want to mess it up. Oh, my God. But listen, yeah. Welcome, honey. Welcome. How are you?
I'm doing very well, and I'm in my fourth year of medical studies. I'm a medical student in Bulgaria at the moment.
Okay, all right. So you left us here in Canada when to go to Bulgaria?
So it was in the height of the pandemic. So it was around the end of 2020, and I started my first year of medical school here.
Wow. Now, why did you choose Bulgaria, huh?
Well, first of all, like, my family's from here. So out of all the different places that I was looking at in Europe, I thought, you know, it might be a good idea to go back to my roots, study somewhere where maybe I know the language, I can get something out of maybe doing, you know, clinical rotations. And also, I think, like, it's an option that a lot of people who are studying in Canada, even in high school, doing their bachelor's degrees, they don't consider medical school or just grad school abroad. And, you know, I would have loved to be in Canadian medical school as well. But I think personally, at the time, you know, I got the acceptance. I just applied, but I was accepted. I was just so happy. And, you know, I decided to go along with it. And it's been quite an amazing journey so far.
You know, my love, I'm so glad you shared that part. I really am glad. That's why you're such a great speaker. But not only that, again, you always think outside of the box. Did you put out applications within Canada as well as abroad?
For medical school, no, because in Canada, you do need a bachelor's degree first, or at least have 3 years of your bachelor's completed to apply to medical school. I did apply to undergraduate programs at the time, but when I received my acceptance here, I just decided to come here. I only applied to one medical school in Bulgaria, by the way, in Varna. I was going to apply to more, but I received my acceptance and I was like, you know what? It's the perfect city. And yeah, I decided to come here.
Wow, my love. Your message is so important because you're studying medicine to students here, the importance of just hanging in there, because I know of a lot right now that's coming to mind that's waiting for just welcome to this university. They're just waiting for that. Can you just share that little piece before we go into some beautiful pictures of your country? What was that like when you were waiting for that acceptance? Like, just share with that, please. A little bit of inspiration for them.
Yeah. Well, you know, there's this quote that you've probably heard of, and I always think of. It's, you know, I'm a huge Harry Potter fan, so it's by Albus Dumbledore. You know, like, there's darkness in the tunnel, but always remember to turn on the light. It's always have this little bit of hope that things will turn out right eventually. And know that if you try your best and put in hard work, and you'll eventually, you know, get to where you want to be. And just have a glimmer of hope, and that can be your guiding light across your journey.
Wow, sweetie. Thank you for that. Thank you. We're going to cover more about your journey and your life and how you're studying and some wisdom words to our students here. But I know you shared some pictures, because when I asked for some pictures, you sent me some gorgeous stuff. Like, I've never been to Bulgaria, but I'm going to just share with the viewers a couple of pieces. And if you can just see the first one that you showed us, it's just absolutely stunning.
Yeah. Okay.
Can you see it?
I can see it, yeah.
All right. Can you talk about that picture for me?
This is a picture of the beach in Varna, the city where I'm studying medicine. So all the pictures that I shared were from the city. And I
Yes.
think I took it somewhere, it was about like the end of October. But yeah, it's really nice when you have a long day, maybe in medical school or in the hospital, just to go down to the beach and maybe study there, just to sort out your thoughts, or maybe even go there in the morning or on the weekend. So it's a good place to kind of go and relax.
Yeah, just mentally relax.
Exactly, yeah.
That's right. There was one that you have there. I'd like to bring that one up of Starbucks.
Yeah. So
Wow.
that's the Starbucks in the city center. But the most interesting part is actually what's inside. So there's another picture of like this glass floor, and there's Roman ruins. Ah, that's the one.
There
Yeah,
you go.
there's so Varna is actually I think one of the oldest civilizations in Europe. So it has a ton of history. So I'm walking on history here, like without knowing it every day. And this just kind of shows you a glimpse of what is underneath the city. So that's why there's this glass floor inside the Starbucks here
Wow.
in the center.
So what
Yeah.
is underneath that glass?
Those are Roman ruins.
Oh my gosh. So
Yeah.
they
They're
literally
like
preserved it.
preserved, yeah.
Holy shit, that is incredible, hon. Now there's another one that's like a church. It's like the ceiling of a church. Am I saying that right? Okay, go on.
That's inside the cathedral in Varna. So I think I might have sent another photo, which shows, yeah, that's the outside of that cathedral, and that was the inside. It's the biggest cathedral in Varna. Well, it's the only one, but yeah, it's just very beautiful, and it shows, I guess, the part of the culture and religion here.
Wow. Did you take that all on your iPhone or an actual, well,
I
phone's
took it
like,
on my iPhone, yeah.
you took those on your iPhone?
Yeah.
They are absolutely stunning, hon. Like gorgeous. The colors is just amazing. So anybody should really, really go there. Like you're studying medical and you're doing in a beautiful country.
Yeah.
Oh my Lord. So now that we've seen some of your pictures, I want to get this message here. So you left here in 2020. You are studying what? What are you studying there, my love?
I'm studying medicine, so yeah, it's a 6-year degree. I'm currently in my 4th year of the
Okay.
medical program. After my 6th year, I'll be a medical doctor. So I think I'm going to graduate maybe November 2026. That's usually when the graduations happen.
Okay, you said think.
Well, I think
Yes.
it's either October or no November, but I know for sure it's the end of 2026.
All right, sweetie. How has the journey been studying? How has that been in doing what you love to do?
Well, I'd say my first, like, first of all, every single year, I've learned quite a few new things along the process. Not only, of course, medical theoretical things, but also I've gotten quite a few insights about life, how I should approach life as well. I think my first and second year were probably, I would say maybe emotionally more difficult because they were for the most part online because of the pandemic. So I
Yes.
didn't really get that experience of, being in person. But after 3rd year, so 3rd year and now 4th year, we've been in the hospital, in the university hospital, talking to patients, just all the time, hearing incredible patient stories and being able to reflect on that. And of course, along the way, just learning everything there is to know about medicine and what we're all very passionate about medicine. So yeah, it's been an amazing journey.
Well, I'm gonna amplify that because I was talking with Dr. Brian Cohen last night on our show, and he mentioned that word passion, and he said it several times throughout the show. But why is passion so important in becoming a doctor and in what you do? Why?
Well, I think many fields of study, not only medicine, but especially medicine, it's very rigorous. It requires a lot of tenacity, a lot of willpower, and there's a lot of work just like studying. And if it's not something you're passionate about, if like it's not your passion, then it's going to be very difficult, you know, to yeah, of course you'll get through your exams, but in the end, like, life is all about finding your passion, doing something you love, like something you love to do for the rest of your life. So that's why I think it's important to be passionate about anything you're doing, not just medicine. So that would go for any field, I'd say.
Thank you. Thank you. That's important coming from you, hon. That's very important. I validate every single word you say, Ilina. I really, really do. That's why you're here. My God, I just forgot what I was going to ask you because I was just wrapped up in that word. I was really, really wrapped up in that word. I don't want to get too deep because we haven't got too long, but when you put on that white coat and you walked in the hospital and you said, I'm actually doing this. How did that feel?
I mean, yeah, beginning of third year, it felt amazing. Everything was just finally setting in and it all felt so real. Because, you know, like I said, first and second year was mostly online. We were even like, we were in the hospital, but only in classrooms doing theoretical things. But once we got to talk to patients, and in my third year, like the whole time I was just telling myself, oh my goodness, I've chosen the right profession. I've chosen like my passion. Like I was right all along. This is really what I want to do. And I'm just so happy that like being in third year now and seeing these patients, and I was just so happy that I'd made the right choice. I think that was really when it started to set in for me that I was on the right path.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
You know, oh my God. Honestly, sweetheart, so many students are going to want to hear that. They want to hear that. Yeah, because that just came from your soul. And on that note, we're going to go to break. We'll be right back with Ilina. Ilina, stay tuned. Thank you. Welcome back to Unwritten Stories of Significance with IIina Kostadinova from Bulgaria, who's studying medicine. IIina, that was incredible.
Thank you.
Oh my gosh, that was incredible. The words that you, throughout the whole segment was incredible, but the words of inspiration that you left for students in whatever they're studying was just so powerful. And I want to thank you from my heart. Thank you, hon. Thank you. Now, you reminded me of something that just happened to you. Look at the smile, folks. So I don't want to forget it. So I need you to share it because I haven't heard of it yet. So
I haven't said anything about it yet now. So yesterday I received an email for some context. Basically, after third and fourth year, we have a mandatory summer internship where we have to spend like a month at the hospital looking after patients in a department. And last year I did it here in Bulgaria, but this year I wanted to see, you know, maybe apply to other places around Europe. And I've always wanted to see what it's like to work in Switzerland. So I applied to Switzerland last month and I got my first job offer for a summer internship there. I got an email yesterday, so I was so happy when I got it.
We just talked about that in the pre-interview. Remember we were talking about you were looking at Sweden or Germany?
Yeah, Switzerland, yeah.
Switzerland. Sorry, guys. Sorry. Okay, I got excited.
But we talked about it in the pre-interview, yeah.
Yes. Oh, my congratulations, sweetheart. Oh my
Thank
gosh,
you.
your eyes tearing up because mine sure are. No, my God. Wow, that's, how did you feel, hon? Can you just share that? Because sometimes we go through so much, but we don't celebrate the good stuff. So how did that feel just opening up and going, holy, yeah.
Yeah, at first I saw the email and I was just like, oh, another email that maybe, they're gonna review my application, something like that. But I opened it and like the first 10 seconds I was just staring at it like, no, really? I just couldn't believe it. Like I literally couldn't believe it. And then I just started pacing around the house like I was so happy and I just wanted to. I called all my family, obviously. I wanted to tell them the great news. And then I got emotional because I wanted to tell my grandfather as well. He was a doctor and he was a big inspiration in like me pursuing medicine, but unfortunately he passed away last year, but I
Oh.
really wanted to tell him that and hopefully he's heard like what has happened, and yeah, hopefully he's watching over me. And yeah, it was just a really emotional day yesterday, and I'm still like really happy about it. I can't believe, after years and years of hard work, and it's finally kind of becoming a reality. So yeah.
Wow. He's right beside you, sweetheart, and he's with you all the time.
Yeah.
And he's right. He knows it. He sees it
Yeah.
and he knows it. He's right beside you every single step of the way. And he'll be there with you too, walking with you through the corridors. He'll be
Yeah.
right there, Heidi, right there beside you. Oh my God. Wow. That is just, that's inc trusting the process. How important is that now? To trust the process when you don't see it, but you still got to believe it.
I think that's the most important thing. I've even like said that to myself, those exact words before, trust the process. There's a long way to go, but just be in the present moment. Just focus on the present moment right now. Be grateful for everything that is happening. Acknowledge everything that's happening. Think about how you're feeling. Just reflect on your emotions. And like I said before, always have that glimmer of hope, that light guiding you down the tunnel of darkness, and you'll find your way if that's if you're pursuing your passion.
That's right, hon.
Yeah.
Now I want to just want to ask you some questions here, and thank you, hon. Thank you for that. Is we spoke within the pre-interview, and you were saying, and I was asking you a lot right now, doing it, studying, but they're not doing anything within the hospitals, like doing any volunteering to strengthen that CV with their degree, but also strengthen their experience working in hospitals and volunteering. Is that important when going into medical school? Like, is that important on the pieces of paper that you submit?
Yeah, I mean, I think it depends on where you're applying. I mean, if you're applying in Canada, the process there is also very rigorous and different. And I know it's important that you have some sort of volunteer experience. Not only, so it looks good on paper, but also to be able to answer the question, why medicine? Why is this your passion? So just having anything that supports that, your why this is your passion, anything like volunteer, whether that's volunteer experience or maybe a personal story, just having a why,
Okay.
that's I'd say the most important thing when applying.
Having the why. All right.
Yeah.
Okay. When I was speaking there with you too, the importance of the relationship, you said that when you were in the hospital and you were walking around and you're doing your stuff and talking to the patients, is that looked upon how you relate your conversation, how your bedside manner is? That's very important too.
Yeah, I think bedside manner is very important. And well, when we're in the hospital, we have like a lot of experience practicing that, but yeah.
Yeah, that's important. No, because the reason why I brought it up is because students ask me that. They ask
Yeah.
that, you know, they ask that if that's in, because some of them just look at the medical side, but they don't realize the relationship between doctor and patient is very important. That trust factor,
Yeah.
right, is important there too.
Yeah.
What I wanted to also ask you, my love, is how do you balance studying so hard and you also work too?
Yeah.
Yeah, so
So
how do you balance all of that, my love?
you know, it isn't easy, to be honest. But yeah, it's honestly just a lot. It requires a lot of discipline, just being able to plan everything out. But the good thing, I guess, in my situation is there's a I work in the family business, so we have an English school, and it's not really like I have set working hours.
Yes.
So I can have some sort of flexibility with my schedule. But in general, yeah, I think it's very important. And you learn it along your journey in medical school. So it's going to come to you gradually, just being able to sort of prioritize and know how to, I guess, structure your schedule.
Yes. I'm
Yeah.
going to ask you this. Did you always know that you wanted to become a doctor?
I would say yes. I'd say probably since I was maybe 5 or 6, I've always said to myself, I'm going to be a doctor one day.
Wow. What sparked it, hon? At such a young age, like really, what sparked you to do it? And then you're following through with it.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like at first it was just my fascination with the human body, the sciences, but over time, it progressed with just being able to interact with people, with patients, hearing other people's stories, which is very important for me, and to, I guess, gain a perspective on life, but also helping other people, combined with my love for sciences and also the intellectual complexity that comes with. I love solving problems and, just medicine, it fits everything. But like I said, also my grandfather, it was a doctor. He has been a great inspiration for me across my whole journey, and I've always looked up to him, and I wanted to be a doctor just like him.
Wow, hon.
Yeah.
That's beautiful, Alina. That's really, really beautiful. Because when I look at you now, when you first graced the show at the time, Future Prospects, then you return back again, and I look at you as a young woman now. You're literally a young woman doing what you want to do. And
Yeah.
that's just beautiful. Anything else you'd like to share? Because my mind is just rolling over here. But is anything that you would like to share to our young people out there? That's doing what they want to do and sometimes get a little bit just unfocused.
Yeah, I mean, I would say it's not a bad thing to be unfocused, but just knowing that there's always like a light at the end of the tunnel, just you have to make sure you're just following your passion, doing what you love. Like, don't like that's the most important thing, I would say.
Yeah, good for you. Have you done any traveling while you're there? Have you gone anywhere? Is that just gone out a little bit? Do you have any time to travel anywhere?
Well, yeah, I've traveled. Well, I mean, first there was the pandemic, but then after that, I've traveled across Europe a bit. I've been to Austria, Vienna, Italy. So it's quite easy to, when you're in Europe, it's quite easy to hop on a plane and just travel around the continent. Next week, I'm going to Poland for a few days,
Wow.
actually.
Well,
Yeah.
that's true because when you're in Europe, everything's just like a, correct me if I'm wrong, it's like a
One
train
to
ride.
2 hour, 1 to 2 hour flight.
Wow. Wow. So you're in a good spot, hon. And you keep in touch with your friends here?
Yeah, I am. Yeah. I mean,
That
I, yeah. from time to time we have, you know, we catch up and sometimes hop on a Zoom call and talk about, you know, what's going on, how they're doing in university, and like what I'm doing here. Yeah.
Beautiful, huh? Well, we're coming up to the end of the show, my love. I want to thank you from the bottom. I thank you for sharing that news. You are going to rock. You are going to do something. Anything you want to say to our students before we go? Anything?
Well, I just wanted to say, yeah, don't be afraid to think outside the box. There's like always other options. Like I grew up in Canada, finished high school in Canada, and I went outside of my comfort zone, you know, coming here, studying medicine. So if that's maybe an option you want to consider studying abroad, then definitely go for it. And yeah, I mean, I'm open to any questions maybe that viewers might have in the future, and they can contact me or anything.
Awesome. So I'll have you back and we can have some questions then. Yay! Thank
Okay.
you, Alina. All the best, sweetheart. Thank you so
Thank
much.
you. Thank you so much for having me.
You're welcome anytime,
Yeah.
Alina. Bye.